All right. Okay. Today we are back with another Pentatonix reaction video. It's been a while.
It's been a very long time, Jordan.
But the people have been requesting that we react to a legendary song.
Yes.
A legendary cover by Pentatonix. I can't wait.
And this legendary cover is from a legendary artist.
Yes.
Of a legendary band.
Yes, sir.
John Lennon from the Beatles.
Yes.
And again, Jared, we say this every time. We are not too familiar with the Beatles, nor John Lennon. But I think I've heard the song Imagine.
You think?
I think.
Every New Year's, Jordan.
How's it go? Hear? How's the song go?
Exactly. Good question. I couldn't tell you off the top of my head.
That's why I said I think.
If I thought long enough, I could tell you. So if you want me to think about it.
Let's not think about it. Let's.
Okay.
Let's get into it.
But when you turn on, you know, the New Year celebration,
yeah,
whatever channel you turn it to, they sing this song every single year.
And for some reason, Jared, just like you, I can't think of what it sounds like.
Yeah.
But you know you've heard it.
I know I've heard it dozens of times. And I probably know the lyrics by this point.
Yeah.
I just can't recall, for some reason, any line from the song.
But think about
that. Off the top of my
head. There are many songs out there like that.
Yeah.
You can't recall them, but you know you've heard them.
Yes.
This seems to be one of those. So, Jared, let's get into some comments. The people have been telling us that this is a must.
Yes.
We must get to this.
All right. So the first comment comes from Alexis Popek. Alexis writes, "Your reactions are fantastic. Like I said the last time, you need to do Imagine. You will experience their wall of sound that will blow your mind. Keep the tissues within arm's reach."
Okay.
Thank you, Alexis. And
you got tissues?
I don't have any tissues, but I do have this crumpled up paper towel that is looks to have been already used, and it's not mine.
Yeah.
But I will keep it in reach, and it must be yours.
I don't think that is mine, but
no? Okay.
I would like a little piece if you could.
Sure.
All right. So the next comment comes from Linda Cogliotti. Linda says, "I'd like to suggest Imagine. At some point, you will feel the chills starting from the fingertips and going up to the nape of the neck." This may just be the best comment I've seen in a while.
It's up there.
So Linda is telling us we're going to feel chills starting in our fingertips and going up the nape of the neck. What's the nape of the neck?
We have to search it up. The nape of the neck.
I want to say it's right here, but I could be wrong. The nape is the back of the neck.
Ooh.
Nape is an interesting word.
It's the part of the neck where when you're in the shower and that warm water first hits.
or
the cold water.
No. Look, when you're in the shower and you have the flu.
Oof.
That hot water hits different.
I don't know if I've experienced that before.
Next time you're sick,
yeah,
get in a hot shower. You won't be able to turn it hot enough.
Ugh.
That's the nape of your neck right there. Chills are just...
All right. You might have a hole in the back of your neck. Like this guy. Okay, so the nape of your neck is just the back...
The back of the neck.
Back of your neck.
Okay. Linda also says, "Thanks for your reactions and greetings from Italy." Thank you, Linda. And we will let you know if we have any chills starting in our fingertips and going up the nape of our necks.
Nape of the neck. I love the alliteration there.
Love it.
Okay. The next comment comes from B-Fly. B-Fly writes, "Please react to their cover, Upgrade, to Imagine. It's an important video, and it's so beautiful, it makes me tear up." Okay, B-Fly is the second person who said it makes them tear up.
Yeah.
I do recall listening to a rendition of Imagine in the past that made me tear up. I will say that. It is such an emotional song that, you know, it can make you tear up very easily.
Yeah.
But I don't think we know what we have in store with Pentatonix here, John.
Yeah. So you remember the feeling you got, just not the lyrics or how the song goes.
Yes, a deeply inspiring and moving song. That's the feeling I got.
When we hear it, we're going to be like, oh, okay.
100%.
I can't even think of how the hook goes, Jared.
Yeah.
It's a shame.
Yeah.
It's a shame.
Yeah, we got to lift up these rocks, Jordan.
These rocks are getting pretty heavy, man.
Yeah.
All right, last comment from Big Matty Matt 82. Big Matty Matt says, their rendition of Imagine by John Lennon is amazing. It's sad to say, but the message they put out in the song is still relevant today. The world needs a positive message right now.
Couldn't have said it better.
Spot on, Big Matty Matt. The world's always in need of a positive message, but definitely these past couple years and past couple months.
Absolutely.
All right. So, Jared, let's just really quick look up John Lennon and the Beatles and his song Imagine before we listen to his version.
All right. So John Winston Ono Lennon, born in 1940, and he died in 1980.
So he was 40 years old.
John Lennon was an English singer, songwriter, musician, and peace activist who achieved worldwide fame as the founder, co-songwriter, co-lead vocalist, and rhythm guitarist of the Beatles.
Okay.
Lennon was characterized by the rebellious nature and acerbic. I've never heard that word.
Acerbic.
What's that mean? Sharp and forthright.
Hmm.
Okay. So Lennon was characterized by the rebellious nature and acerbic wit in his music, writing, and drawings on film and in interviews.
Hmm.
His songwriting partnership with Paul McCartney remains the most successful in history.
And the Beatles was made up of John Lennon, Paul McCartney, Ringo Starr, and George Harrison.
Yes.
So the Beatles were an English rock band formed in Liverpool in 1960 that comprised of all of those individuals. And they are regarded as the most influential band of all time. And were integral to the development of 1960s counterculture and popular music's recognition as an art form.
Mm. And Jordan, I feel somewhat embarrassed that I don't have much knowledge of the Beatles, right? When we see that they are regarded as the most influential band of all time.
Mm.
That doesn't say they are regarded as one of the most influential bands of all time. They are regarded as the most influential band of all time.
Yeah. Legends. John Lennon is a legend. Let's remind ourselves what Imagine sounds like.
Yes, please.
So let's listen to him perform it live in 1975.
Okay.
Before we start, can you... I can't say the hook still. I don't know what the hook's...
I can.
Hold on. Play it over again. Okay. Here we go.
I'm going to stop it.
I should know this, Drew. I've sung it before.
Yeah. Imagine all the living for today. Come on, Jordan.
It's what is that word called?
It's ingrained in you.
That there has to be a word though.
Yeah.
For songs that you forget the melody to.
Yeah.
But that live inside of you, and as soon as you hear the words, you instantly remember. You've heard it thousands of times, hundreds of times. What's the word? There has to be a word for that.
Yeah, let us know what that word is, because we have some music historians and experts out there.
Absolutely. If there is a word for it,
there's got to be.
I got it now.
All right, Jarn, this is going to be magic.
All right, here we go.
Let's go.
Okay, I got it now.
That song lives inside of you?
Oh, that song has lived inside of me for a long time.
Yes. Yeah. Probably since the time you were in the womb.
That's crazy.
Oh, yeah. One somewhat minuscule line from this song that stuck out to me and has stuck out to me in the past when I've heard it. It said, imagine no possessions.
Mm-hmm. That stuck out to me too.
I wonder if we can. And I just thought, I don't think so.
You don't think we can imagine?
I don't think we can imagine a world in which there is no possessions. Mm. We have gotten to a point, Jordan, where I think we've surpassed that. I think possessions have now become interwoven with the human body. Mm. You know, we wear Apple Watches. We got virtual goggles. Mm-hmm. And we have smartphones that are either at our hip or in our hands nearly every waking and sleeping moment of the day and night. Mm. I don't think we can imagine a world where there's no possessions.
In this country, in America, and in many places in the world, possessions mean everything. We live in a capitalistic society over here.
Yes.
Where you produce, and people buy, and consume. And it's never enough.
Yes.
That's what I took that as. But yeah, I think we're saying pretty much the same thing.
Oh yeah.
The other thing that sort of got me was he's saying imagine. He's not saying like we need this or you need to do this, or he's saying just imagine. Just imagine a world that's peaceful Just imagine. Imagine that. And when he was saying that, Martin Luther King was just popping in my head, because Martin Luther King had a dream, you know, for peace. And John Lennon seems like he's very, very attuned to the issues at the time, like we read.
Yeah.
But also very slick with the way he does things, with the way he did things.
Yeah, his presence.
Yeah, just a very calming presence.
Yes.
But an important voice. That's John Lennon to me. I don't know too much else about him, but
100%. And just one more quick point about the word imagine.
Yeah.
Right? He said, imagine a world where we live as one.
Yes.
Right? And it's very difficult to imagine that when you think about the geography and, you know, how borders are drawn. However, when astronauts come back from space and tell us that they don't see borders, they're no longer imagining, Jordan.
Mm-hmm.
That's real. We are one people. We are one people on this feeble earth. You know?
Maybe Elon's onto something.
I mean, maybe Elon can get us all up to space so we can truly feel and know what it means to be one, where we don't have to imagine.
Perspective.
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 But we're going to need more than Elon.
Yeah. All right, Jared, let's check out Pentatonix version of this, man.
Let's go.
They say it's an upgrade.
Mm. And that word in and of itself is an understatement. Mm. Most times when we listen to Pentatonix. Yeah.
All right, let's check this out. So this is Pentatonix Imagine, and it's a music video. Here we go.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try.
Mitch.
That's Mitch.
Ooh, that's Mitch.
I wonder if you care. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood of men. All the people share.
Air Identities. Wow. Hold up. Ooh.
I'm a dreamer.
Jared, that's Kevin. He's the beatboxer, Jared. Yeah.
But I'm not the only one.
Don't forget he can sing, Jared.
I hope someday you'll join us.
And
the world will live as one.
Human. They're all human. Look, that's it. That's human. That's it, Jordan. Human. 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 What were they doing there with the many different identities, right? The many different words to describe each of them, I think. They were sharing their unique identities. Sharing it with each other? Sharing it with us. But look, they were passing down the line, right? They were going down the line with the board.
Yes.
So they started with LGBTQ.
Yes.
Was that Mitch saying he identifies as LGBTQ?
That's what I assume, yes.
Okay. And then you had, I wrote it down, then you had man.
Exactly.
On there. And American was next.
Yes.
And then I couldn't keep track of the rest of them, but.
Yes. You had black. Yeah, Jewish.
Latina.
Jordan, all these different identities, whether it's a racial identity, religious identity, gender, all these different identities, Jordan. That's who I am. But at the end of the day, I'm human.
And that's often an understatement. That's often just said as a cliche.
Yes.
I'm human. Treat me like I'm a human.
I'm human. This was powerful because human is made up of five letters.
Ah, that's a good point.
There are five members of this group that going down the line, Jordan, have just about as much diversity as you will find anywhere in the world.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
This was extremely well done.
And the fact that, like you said, there's five letters in human.
Yeah.
They all depend on each other, right?
Yeah.
Not just because they're a group, but because they're all human.
Yes.
Jared, we're in this world with billions of people.
Yeah.
Right? Billions of people. And a lot of times we're fed information, maybe from the media, maybe from different places, that says to us our view of the world or our race is the best, is the better race.
Yeah.
And I'm just speaking our in general or your, you know, you can grow up getting those messages fed to you. And you can also grow up receiving messages of hate that tell you, your race, your gender, your identity is bad. It's the worst. Those are two different experiences growing up.
And then there's the third option.
Yeah.
You can grow up to view every single person that you encounter as a human being. It may be rare nowadays.
Yeah, I was going to say, is it rare?
But it still happens, Jordan.
Yeah.
It still happens. There was a very interesting moment at the end here where they all broke into their various improvisational sections.
Okay.
But at the end, they all came together in unison.
Ah.
And I thought that sort of was an example of the message behind this song, Jordan. We're all different. I can do this with my voice. I can do this. As you mentioned, we saw Kevin sing. What?
But Jared, we know he's trained in that.
Yes.
He's a trained musician, a singer.
Mm.
But he's also all these other things.
Oh, yeah.
And so I think that, look, that might be why they had him sing in this song. Mm. To show that you're not just one thing.
Yes.
You're not just a beatboxer. Just like you're not just a black man.
Yeah.
You can be multifaceted. You're a human being. You are supposed to be multifaceted.
Yes.
And Kevin has a beautiful voice. Mitch caught me off guard as well because his voice.
Angelic.
Very, very powerful.
Yeah, we got Mitch slapped. But let's play that last part really quickly.
Okay.
Where they improvise for a little bit and then they all come back together.
All right. I hope someday you'll join us.
In the world we live is one. Right here. Yeah. Ah.
Oh, hold on. Woo! The chills appeared at the nape of my neck.
Ooh.
I'm not joking. I am not joking. I missed that for some reason when I was watching the first time. Jared, the chills came to the nape of my neck.
At
they did not
point?
Travel at the point where they reverberated after they had just gotten done with that unison.
Yeah.
Can I replay that?
Yes.
The unison, you hear it reverberate. It's like... what's the effect called, Jared? Reverb. They just created their own reverb.
Reverberate.
Reverberate.
Reverb.
Linda was right. It didn't come from my fingertips, though.
Yeah. Can I check on it quick? Is the back of your neck? Make sure you don't have a hole in it. Yeah, you should be all right.
I'm good?
Yeah, you're good.
I didn't expect that.
Yeah.
Let me see.
You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will live as one.
Come on, Jordan.
Oh, yeah.
Right? A beautiful, beautiful, beautiful rendition. Beautiful rendition of this song. And what Pentatonix always seems to do is go the extra mile. Right? They're not just going to give a beautiful rendition of the song and make it sonically pleasing and make all of their various voices fit together. What they're going to do are hold up signs with letters on them that add up to human. That's what they're going to do.
Spot on. Yep. I think the reason I got chills the second time and not the first was because you said, did you see them have their solos and then come back as one?
Yes.
When they came back as one, that was a pitch perfect moment. And I don't mean to have a pun involved in there.
No.
That was pitch perfect. Nobody stepped on anybody's toes. They sounded like one.
Yes.
Whatever one sounds like. You obviously hear different voices. They sounded like one. But that was intentional.
That was 100% intentional. And they just made a huge statement here, right? We, in all of our diversity, all of our different identities, all of our different vocal abilities,
yeah,
can demonstrate to you the beauty that exists within each of these individual identities on their own. But what's going to give you chills,
yeah,
on the nape of your neck is the human identity.
Mm.
Is being human, realizing that we are one.
Mm-hmm.
We are one.
Everything they did here musically, like you said, humanly, yeah, technically, they did it with intention and with the intention of inviting us in,
yes,
to be human with them.
Yes.
Very powerful song. Everybody was right.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody was spot on with their comments.
I didn't have to use the tissue, but, you know, maybe if I listen to it again,
yeah,
I may need it.
All right. Thank you all so much for watching our video today. If you enjoyed it, make sure you leave a like, leave a comment down below, and subscribe if you haven't already.
And don't forget to turn on those notifications. But most importantly, be kind
and keep an open mind, everybody.
Peace. Imagine all possessions.